to being God.
Right, Lightning. Let's punish his fist. Oh shit, the tentacles. I've been fighting this guy in a long time. I hope I won't fuck this up. Just for the record, I just wanna say that this is one of my favorite bosses in this game, man. If not one of the best Resident Evil period bosses. I just think it's, everything about it is awesome. That music in the background. Damn you, Irving, you crazy bastard. What happened, Lightning? He's calling me for something. Oh, yeah. Thanks for reminding me, buddy. That's a big point. It's gonna do the bite. Wait, what? What? Shit! I never see doing this attack before. Oh, no.
No! Shit!
Lightning, help! Thanks, man. Oh my god, thank you. I never saw this boss doing this attack before. Oh shit, here we go again. What the hell? I have fought this boss like 20 times before and I never saw him doing that attack before. Well, it's time for me to shut up because I want you to enjoy this music too. Never easy to beat Chris Redfield.
Thank you.
planning to do?
Damn, Excella! I guess I wasn't worth the good stuff.
Excella?
Where is this facility? Answer me! What is the Ouroboros project?
BSAA!
Wow, you two are just on top of everything, aren't you? The balance of the world is changing and you're completely oblivious to it.
What's changing? What are you talking about? Is it the Ouroboros project? Is that it?
No one can stop it. Ouroboros is about to change everything we've ever come to know.
Chris!
You're Chris.
What's so funny? How do you know about me?
All your answers are way to head, Chris. In that cave. If you can survive long enough to get them. Dying's not so bad, but it's not gonna change anything. You're still screwed!
We're wasting time here.
Chris!
Now what?
We keep going. So this is the place he was talking about.
That's the boat the woman used to get away.
So, you two are really going to go through with this?
Yes.
This is not just about Jill, but the Ouroboros project as well.
I guess there's nothing I can do to stop you. I will call HQ and try to get the withdrawal order rescinded. I will also try to get you back up. Try not to get yourselves killed.
Thanks.
Thanks.
That name Irving said, Excella.
You've heard it before?
That's the name of the director of Tricell's African division.
Do you think she could be connected to Irving?
It's possible, but I don't have any proof.
Tricell. If there is a connection, what does that mean for Africa?
Not sure, but if we keep going, we're bound to find out.
True. Let's move.
The motorboat's key is missing. Yeah, that was a good fight, man. The boss. I like I always like the concept of the fight. And the way everything about it looks and feels. This cave looks pretty awesome, too. Here, we're gonna have a new type of enemy. Well, several type of new enemies for this series.
Thanks.
Well, let me see it. No, I think it's only one. One
okay.
Enemy. And they're super weak to the bomb that I got in my hand. So yeah, that was one of my favorite bosses in this game. Irving. But shit. Creepy bastards. So yeah, they are photosensitive.
Okay.
Just like most of abominating creatures, they're sensitive to the light. Damn it, gotta get out of here. If I don't,
thanks,
they're gonna jump on my face. Except to suck on my blood. Thank you. Oh yeah, the chest. Thanks, man. Almost forgot there's a chest here. And I think there is also a gem. Yeah, that one.
Thanks. Thanks.
Thank you, Lightning, for trying to show me things that I may have forgotten. There's an area right here. I'll try to jump down. I wasn't sure if it was going to jump on my face. There's a pretty cool animation that Chris does if one of those things grab your partner.
Thanks.
You can check it away with the knife. Oh yeah, there's an emblem here. What is with this view, man? I cannot see where I am. I hate when that shit happens, man. Shoulder or the elbow gets in the middle of my sight, you know, where I'm supposed to aim. Careful, man. Nice one. And that is how you deal with the bio terror. Especially if they're creepy looking fucking spiders. I hate spiders. I really do. Yeah. Oh, behind you. Oh shit.
I need your help. Thanks, partner.
I love that. I just love the way Chris looks when he does that shit, man. I just, I don't know. He looks so... so, like, heroic, you know? Now, from this door on, I just got a bad feeling about it. All kind of bad things can happen to us here.
Never knew such a place existed here.
It looks like there's been some recent activity.
I hope Irving was telling the truth when he said we'd find answers in this place.
It's very beautiful look in the place. And an emblem over there. Now, a lot of people may say, what the hell? This looks more like a Tomb Raider setting or Indiana Jones setting than a Resident Evil, but again, there's a reason why they're here in these ancient ruins. It's not because of the place that they're here, but it's because what they hide in here. So it will make a lot of sense of why they're in this place. Aside, of course, Capcom trying a different environment for the series. Anyway, in Resident Evil 4, there is a very similar place to this. Spider. I think he hates spiders, just like me. I think in all modern Resident Evil, like 4, 5, and 6, there is an area a lot like this. I was expecting some kind of interaction here. I think he's telling me, okay, here. Something's hanging here. I don't want to even think what it might be. Shit. That's how I feel about that sack of bag that the villagers are kicking and pushing at the very beginning of the game. It always makes me think, what the hell is in that bag, you know? You wanna grab it? You do? Alright, help you then. We're not really caring too much about grabbing gold. We're not going to upgrade our weapons anyway, but we can buy proximity mines and other bombs. Ah, this area, man. It can be a pain if you're not careful. We shall see what the hell's gonna happen. Cause this place and me, we don't really have a good history together. Got to be honest, we had to retry this area because a lot of bad things happened to me, and then we decided to retry it again because I was doing too poorly. Now there's this very nasty ambush here, and he's telling me that I should stay up here and cover him from up here. And I think maybe he's right about that, since I totally forgot the strategy that I used to have for this area. Well, I think I never had one to start with.
Thanks.
It's just always a train wreck or survival, you know? Shit. Get assassinated, buddy. Okay. He don't want me to gun down because I think it's because I'm gonna aggro more enemies. Yeah, I remember there is enemies in this room in front of me. You can even hear them somehow.
Roger.
Want me to go now? Right. Yeah, you hear a sound in there. They sound like snakes. Shit. Are you sure about this? Get boom, bitch. Good one, man. Yeah, I think I get an abs area. You know, when you go down and you're trying to help your partner, which is what I did, I went down in a rush to help him. And then I got ambushed in the back, you know, so it's kind of a well-set trap for the co-op playing. If you go down there, you're just gonna aggro more enemies, and that's not what you want. You want to get rid of each enemy at a time, you know, before things are getting worse. So that's our advice. Oh man, look at this. Look at this poor guy. A mummy in a sarcophagus. Maybe this place was a burial ground. It's Imhotep.
Thanks.
I wonder how the new movie... There is an upcoming reboot of Mummy, which a part of me don't care. Because I really love, you know... Yeah, of course I love the classic, original Mummy movie, but
wait.
Okay.
The Stephen Sommers version, you know, the one that Brenda Fraser is, the very popular of the, I think it's of the 2000, I don't think that can be beaten, you know, and those movies, they don't need a remake. But now... The interesting thing about this remake is that it looks like they replaced Imhotep for a female version of Imhotep. So now it's gonna be a female instead, a male, the mummy. And I admit, I mean, she looks really cool in the movie, but, you know, I don't see how the hell they put the Tom Cruise character. I guess he's doing the character of O'Neill, you know. I don't see how that can be better than Brendan Fraser, man. Brendan Fraser is a far more charismatic and more underrated character, man. Or actor. Oh, this area, man. Be ready for some clusterfuck. Because things are gonna get pretty ugly here. I'm actually happy that he's coming with me. I feel more safe now. Got to keep looking around all the time because there's some enemies that they can sneak behind you or under you. Like these spiders, they can appear below you or these tribal warriors, they can appear from your back. He's calling me. Watch out. Oh man, they got me now. Fuck, I'm coming. I'm getting burned up. I got a... Shit. I took really bad damage. We are... Wait. Give me a second, Lightning. Let me... I don't wanna die here. Wait. I think he wants me to restart the game. Alright, let's do it. Okay, so... Try to... Take two, or whatever. Hopefully this time we do better. That's the thing, you know. When... Get off of my friend. When gamers are, you know, at the level of Lightning, every time we do a mistake, we're always feeling that, you know, that we can do better. So we're trying for the sake of that. We are not trying to do a flawless playthrough here, but at least we're trying to do it somewhat decent. Little bitch. Fuck out of my face. Did you get close to my partner now? No, you won't. Oh, you too, friend. I owe you too. Shit! Get off her. I feel bad. One behind me right now. It is behind me. I know. God damn it. What the hell was that view, man? I couldn't see anything. Thanks, man. Cameras, when you get too close to the wall, sometimes they can do this real weird, glitchy camera views, you know. But yeah, we did better now. At least I didn't go burn up. And... Get out of here. Oh yeah, thanks man. Oh no. You see, that's another problem that probably he was taking some damage because I'm sure he's lagging a lot on his side and we just got disconnected now. So I'm gonna have to improvise solo to reach the next checkpoint so I can... Be careful. So I can summon him again. Okay, give me that grenade. Not that one, the other one. That one.
Give me a grenade.
At least I got this with me. It's gonna be really, really helpful if I do it right. Fair enough. Sorry, buddy, but you're trying to kill me with your spears and with your biohazard sickness. Thank you, Sheva. Now, I think there is a checkpoint.
I need ammo.
Use this.
once we get to that crank in front of me.
Thanks,
hopefully, Spartan. Before we activate the trap. There's an emblem over here, I just want to point it out. I don't care to shoot it, fuck it, but I just want to let you know, in case you don't know, that it's there. The emblem, I mean. And the checkpoint, yes. Let's summon the mighty lightning. And Fidelis is back.
Come on, come on.
We've been struggling a lot with internet connection today. It's been really, really shitty. I guess I'm gonna shoot that after all. This area is some Indiana Jones BS here. Run for your lives. Shit. Damn it. That was close.
Come on.
Exactly. Too much loot in this area. I think we are mainly going to grab mostly ammo, but we're not caring too much about the gold. I'm coming. It would be nice if the internet connection would leave us alone. Wow, this looks awesome, man. Look at the bats.
Use this.
Of course, we got disconnected again. Well, after this door, I'm gonna... Well, I'll just restart the game, and Lightning is back in here. This area, I don't like it at all. It's just too cliche, man, too... What is with that mighty jump? The Belmont wonders. Ah, Capcom. Wow, you got to make it look so Hollywood. Still, this is far better than all the piece of shit Hollywood movies, Resident Evil movies together, rolling to one. Far better. I don't think any of the movies can be compared to this game. Except for the CGI movies made by Capcom based on the true timeline of Biohazard. Fuck the movies. Yeah. It has some beautiful sexy ladies in it. But that's it. I personally, I really love the incarnation of Jill Valentine, the movie in Resident Evil 2, because I think the actress, she's just gorgeous, man, and I really love that girl.
Thanks.
She did look really good for Jill. I don't know if she did the best acting possible for her, but the way she looked, you know, her incarnation felt right. But that's the only thing I can say I like about Resident Evil 2, the fucking movie. Oh, okay. Also, they brought the Nemesis. And you look okay. But that's it. Fuck Alice and fuck all the Mila Jovovich bitch movies. Stay with my sexy Claire Redfield and my Jill Valentine. And the mighty Chris Redfield. Oh, fuck yes. Also, I want to see my Billy Cohen back into the series. That would make me so happy. Really hoping that after Resident Evil 7, we get another Resident Evil Revelations continuation. And if they bring Billy Cohen back, that's just gonna make my day. But at the same time, we need to know what happened with Jill Valentine. You know, after this game, we don't know what happened to her. And we don't even know why she even wasn't on Resident Evil 6. Hopefully she was pregnant from Chris. And that's the reason why...
Come on.
Because you think about it, okay, I like Pierce Nevins, you know, he's a great character, he saved Chris so many times. But wouldn't it have been way more epic if Jill were the partner of Chris, you know, in Biohazard 6? Now, I guess the excuse for that is that they had planned to have a tragic ending. Well, spoilers if you don't know, I guess. I'm talking, you know, thinking that most of you will know the ending of Resident Evil 6, Chris Redfield campaign, but... Of course, they won't put... Like, if they make Jill die or Chris die, it will be... a horrible blow for the fan base, you know. Tell you what, man, if they kill Chris, I'm gonna stop caring for Resident Evil, I think Resident Evil's gonna die for me. Unless, I mean, he has to have a glorious, legendary falling, you know. It has to be, I don't know, like him saving the world again. Now, something I forgot to brought to the light is how I met for the first time my partner here, Lightning Fidelis, in reality. And it was while playing Resident Evil 6, Chris Redfield campaign. I remember let's wait for the sound effect to go away because it's gonna be a lot of noise. I remember that I was playing as Pierce. Well, he was playing as Chris, right? And I joined his game. And I remember we were doing this, the bunker area at the end of the, nearly the end of the campaign, and
come on.
He was okay. Just sitting there slaughtering invaders, you know, they invade you as hunters, trying to kill the agent, and it was fun. Now these guys are not fun. Trying to skin us alive. And wear our skins are as masks. There's one with the Koopa over there. Shit, the headshot.
Work.
Indeed. Just kill them all, man. Well, it sounds terrible, but the truth is that we need to release them from their curse. for their humanity is long gone. Sadly. Watch behind you, man. The Lightning, bro. He loved to do that. He loved the combo chain, melee attacks. What can I say about it? He just loved that. It's very fun to do it with him, really.
Wait.
Roger.
I remember the last very horrible ambush that's gonna happen here. Shit, it already happened. Get out of my face. Don't look at me like that, you little shit. Damn it, it's one behind me. Yeah, it's just, it's one in front of you. God damn it, complete miss. Nice. Just kill them all.